process diagram helps us lay out kind of an overall picture of what it is that we plan to do, who's involved in doing it, and most of all, we're focusing on how we are doing the elements that we need to do to from our organization, and how are we spending our resources to meet the customers' needs, their requirements, and their expectations. How does the diagram or process help the organization? First of all, you identify what it is you do, when you do it, and find out, are there gaps? Are there things that you intend to do but you aren't doing? Or are there things you're doing that could be improved, that could do better? Sometimes it could be duplication or redo that takes place. So we want to, by using that diagram and laying out the picture, maybe it's taking too long to do certain steps. We begin to see those identified items when we're looking at that picture and putting it on paper on the wall, so to speak. What questions do we ask? It's quite a long list, but some highlights are we need to ask about who are the customers and who are the suppliers involved in this particular process. Other questions that we ask is, what is the process flow? What's taking place during periods of time, from the beginning to the end, but in the steps along the way? Another one is, what are the process steps? Who does what when? And often how? What are the support systems that are involved with this particular process? Could be the use of computers, could be many things that are support systems. So when we lay all those things out, we begin to see the overall picture of the process. But we ask, are there steps missing, things we should be doing, we're not doing? Are there duplications? Are we redoing? A big one is the redo. We didn't get it right the first time, now we got to start all over again. Very similar to the kinds of things we're doing now. We might have to start all over again. So quite important to find those elements and eliminate them and get it where we go start to finish quickly. It's very, very common to find that by going through and analyzing a process, that we'll find that we can reduce the time it takes to do that process in the quality that we did, to do it right the first time kind of step, that we could cut those process times in half or even less.
Root cause analysis is a problem-solving technique that answers three questions. Why did the problem occur in the first place? What caused the problem? What is a possible solution, one that reduces the likelihood of the problem happening again?
Oftentimes it's called RCA, or root cause analysis practices, tries to solve problems by attempting to identify and correct the root cause of an event, not the symptoms of it. We use that root cause analysis to go back and find what are the items that are driving our processes, making things good or making things bad, by getting to the core, not the symptoms. The symptom is we have to redo. But in fact, if we find out why we have to redo, we're getting to the cause.